Summer is here, and the 12 mini deal just got even hotter. The iPhone 12 mini is now one penny with a two-year contract. Visit an Appalachian Wireless retail location or go to AppalachianWireless.com to view this amazing deal. We are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
To ensure that local first responders are prepared when someone needs medical attention, a first aid CPR training class was offered at the Martin Fire Department Monday evening.
State Fire Rescue, they provide training to fire departments like Martin Fire Department, but tonight we're here doing medical training. We're doing CPR and first aid training. Tonight's class was actually open to all first responders in and around Martin Fire Department, and that includes all of Floyd County and even neighboring counties as well. There are several people here that are not members of this specific fire department, but from other fire departments who are here tonight to get certified in CPR and first aid.
The class offered training in both adult and infant CPR and first aid, preparing first responders for situations that may involve a child or infant.
There'll be several things in the first aid class, like stopping the bleed, taking care of patients who possibly have signs and symptoms of stroke or cardiac event, along with like anaphylaxis and things like that. So they'll get a wide variety of training tonight here at the class.
City of Martin firefighter Chase Shepherd says that their members are taking the class to not only serve and protect while on duty, but in case they are needed outside of work.
I mean, we may roll up on an accident, we may roll up on somebody having difficulty breathing, and depending on if EMS is available close by us, this CPR class will definitely benefit our department.
Being someone who has already been through CPR and first aid training, Shepherd says not only do firefighters need to be certified in CPR, but they need refresher courses so they can perform CPR properly.
It's a lot of mind knowledge, but you got to use it in a proper way, especially on a child, infant, and adult. There's different ways that you have to do it. And everybody's going to leave tonight, and they're going to be very knowledgeable about CPR and first aid.
Before CPR begins, participants learned how to determine what is wrong with the patient, how to check for a pulse, and what to do if the patient has no pulse or isn't breathing.
After that, then it comes 30 compressions and two breaths that go along with that, and that's for both infant, child, and adult. The only difference basically is the size of the equipment that we'll use to give those breaths and whether or not we'll use one hand or two hand depending on the size of the patient.
And although Shepherd says he has yet to perform CPR as a firefighter, he wants to make sure he is properly trained when the time comes to save a life.
I'm gonna guess around 10 to 13 years been on the fire department. I've never had to perform CPR. Hope I never do, but if I have to, I'll do everything I can to save a life.
I'm thankful to be here tonight. The more people we can get certified in CPR, the better chance somebody has of living if they do have to experience a cardiac arrest.
Reporting for Mountaintop News, I'm Jeremy Justice.